In this video, I will present you the ECAD Importer with the latest capabilities of version 22.1.0. Its purpose is to facilitate the creation of ANSA databases that faithfully represent the 3D geometry of printed circuit boards by importing ECAD data from IPC 2581 Revision B files. Various 3D models can be generated from the same file with the help of this plugin, according to the selected level of modeling detail. There are four levels of detail for the board, which will be explained starting from the simplest to the most detailed. Homogeneous board. The whole board here is modeled as a homogeneous volume. Neither layers nor vias are imported. The geometry of the metallic features is absent from the final board. However, it is possible to calculate the total volume percentage of copper across the whole board. Homogeneous layers. At this level, both conducting and dielectric layers of the PCB are imported as layers of finite thickness. The user can choose whether vias will be imported or not. The geometry of the metallic features is again not present. However, the volume percentage of metal in each conducting layer can be calculated. Full 2D metallization. At this level of detail, each dielectric layer is imported as a homogeneous volume. The conducting layers are represented by flat zero thickness interfaces. The exact geometry of the conducting features is imported and represented by flat faces. The vias of the board are also imported. Full 3D metallization. The only difference with the full 2D metallization is that some of the boundaries separating the dielectric layers are shifted either upwards or downwards by the thickness of the adjacent conducting layers. And the orientation of the faces is chosen according to this shift. The reason is to prepare the model for layered mesh generation after the import of the 3D model has finished. Let's see now how the ECAD Import Wizard works. The tool is contained in the plugins and it guides the user through different stages depending on the options in the first page. The first page is the introduction where the model detail is selected. There are three blocks of choices. The first controls the detail of the board, the second the vias, and the third the components. In the board detail, the user can select among the four available options: homogeneous board, homogeneous layers, full 2D metallization, and full 3D metallization. At the second block, the user can select if he wants to drill vias in models with homogeneous layers. And finally, there is the third block where the user can choose to import components and create the pins of the components. Let's create the most detailed model. Full 3D metallization with components and with pins. In the first stream, the file that we want to open has to be selected. IPC 2581 files are in XML format, which have the extension either .xml or .cvg. Then we press to load the IPC file. A new model is going to be generated, and we get a message that the IPC file was read successfully. In the next stage, an overview of the stackup is given. The layers of the PCB are presented. Their names as they are contained in the file, their functionality, their thickness in micrometers, and their material in the final column. Their colors are assigned according to their functionality and material. So if a layer is a conductor, it is either yellow or red. The red layers are plane layers, which means layers that are almost exclusively made out of metal. The green layers are the isolating dielectric layers. it is also possible to select which layers are going to be admitted by unchecking the checkbox in the Import column. Here the thickness of each layer can become editable by activating the Edit Layers Thickness checkbox. And with Accept Stackup, you get a summary of how the final stackup will look like. If the user is not satisfied, he can press Undo Stackup. There is also the option to fuse layers less than the specified distance apart. So, in case a fake very thin dielectric layer exists, the dielectric layer is omitted and the two conducting layers are fused into one with a thickness of the sum of them and a name that will be a union of the names. There is also an extra column which is available only for this level of detail, extrude, which indicates in which direction copper layers will be extruded in order to swift the conducting layers away from the dielectric core. The distances of the layer interfaces have been modified because the layers have been shifted and the correct orientation of the interfaces is chosen so that the extrusion of the mesh will happen correctly. The layers will be extruded in the right direction through the mesh menu after finishing the wizard. At the next stage, we can import the 2D features as curves. These curves are the boundaries of the metallic elements of the PCB. Here we have a set of basic and advanced options. First of all, we can specify the resolution which affects the mesh length. Then we have two options regarding features without finites, which are usually mechanical features or descriptive elements. We can either import all the features without finites or just the vias. Another option that accelerates the performance is to ignore features that lie outside of the PCB profile. So curves that lie outside of the PCB profile in the end will not be present. Let's import the 2D features. So now all the 2D features are imported as UNSA curves at the correct Z level. In the next page, the user will create the profile of the PCB, which is the 3D box that will contain all the features of the PCB. We have three options. The first one is to import the profile geometry that is contained in the IPC file. We click on the button Apply PCB Profile, and we get this imported geometry, which is a 3D box with the correct thickness and all the interfaces that contain all the layers. Here only dielectric layers are imported as thick slices of material. As homogeneous layers, and the conducting layers will be imprinted on the zero thickness interfaces between these layers. In case this 3D box information does not exist inside the IPC file, the user can use either of the other two options. If we are not satisfied with this profile, we delete it by pressing Delete PCB Profile. We can choose to use the bounding box of all the curves of the PCB profile. When activating this option, we can give a box expansion percentage. Let's apply this. A 3D rectangular box enclosing all feature curves with the specified box expansion percentage is created. Finally, there is the option to use custom curves. The user can select his own curves from the model to build his own PCB profile. First, we have to create some curves. We put them in the lateral boundaries part in the model browser. We use Pick Curves and we select the curves that will build the PCB profile. We get a message that the curves that we selected are valid, and then we can apply the PCB profile and a custom profile is created. We can select any simple chain of curves. We can delete this PCB profile now and use the default option. 2D topology. This stage is the stage of the 2D topology. Here all the curves that define the metallic features will be projected onto the dielectric interfaces and will create the metallic faces. There are only two options for the acceleration of 2D topology. Fast 2D topology. With this option, the fastest method for creating the conducting faces of the PCB is used. and is suggested only if the finites of the board do not overlap. Acceleration by fusing features of the same finite. This option is recommended to be enabled and will fuse the feature boundaries that belong to the same finite. After this step is finished, you get a table of the results for each layer. The name, the status, which if it is not OK, there is a yellow exclamation mark instead of a green tick, and we get the number of failed metallic features. If there are failed features, in the end, they are the only curves which remain, and a set is created containing the curves grouped per failed feature, so the user can manually project them and create the feature. 3D topology. The next step is the drilling of the board and the placement of the vias. This is a single-click step which drills the board at the locations where vias should be drilled and places the homogeneous cylinders there and connects them topologically to the whole board. Component import. Here we get a summary of all the components that are going to be imported. We have the name of the package, the type, how many times this package occurs on the board, the number of pins that it has, their thickness, and their standoff, which is their distance from the board, are editable. So you can set a uniform standoff here for all the components. We press Import Components and all components are imported. At the last page of the wizard, the user can select to create batch meshing scenarios by defining the target element length and the number of mesh layers for the traces, in case full 3D metallization is desired. Volume scenarios can also be created upon request. Let's inspect the components. The components have pins which are topologically connected to the body of the packages. Each package of the same type has the same property, and the properties have the name of the packages. There are three possible types of pin properties: pin through, pin surface, and pin blind. Apart from the pin properties, there are the PEC property, which is used for the conducting vias, the dielectric properties, which are the properties of the dielectric interfaces, the lateral property, which is the property of the lateral boundaries and of non-plated mechanical vias, and all different packages have their own property, and finally we have the conducting properties of the individual layers. Let's see the database structure of the model. We have four main parts. The lateral boundaries, which are the boundaries that contain our PCB in the XY direction. The vias, the 3D cylinders that connect all layers together. The layers, which are structured according to the stack-up of the PCB. Each layer is divided into two parts, the dielectric and the PEC part. And we have a group with the components, which is subdivided in top and bottom components, and further subdivided where each component is a separate UNSA part. So C usually means capacitor, R is a resistant, and U is an integrated circuit. Another database structure feature of the model is the sets. There is a set called component pins, which groups together the pins of the components with their respective landing faces on the board, divided into subsets for each layer, and then further subdivided for each component. We have also grouped the faces according to the physical nets, finite, information which is useful for the electromagnetic simulations of the PCB. Thank you for watching.